Hey everyone, Rusty here at Blue Robotics. Today I'm going to walk you through some of the cool features and design of the T200 Thruster. We designed this thruster to be high performance, reliable, and flexible enough to use in applications ranging from hobbyist projects to high-end research vehicles to autonomous underwater vehicles and even to human-carrying vehicles like kayaks. It can do all of this while being extremely compact and affordable. There's a few cool parts of our patented design that make that possible. Historically, most ROV thrusters are designed with an off-the-shelf electric motor that's housed in an air or oil-filled tube to protect it from the water. A shaft seal or a magnetic coupling generally transfers the power from the motor out into the water and to the propeller. We took a very different approach. Instead of protecting the motor from the water, we made a motor that is inherently water and pressure proof. That makes for a motor with just one moving part, fewer parts overall, a compact size, and a significantly more affordable price. Let's take a look inside. I've got a disassembled thruster right here. At the core of the thruster is the motor stator. In here is an iron core and copper windings, which are contained in an overmolded material that's waterproof and electrically resistant. There's a stainless steel stem in the center that holds the thruster bearings. And unlike most motors, which use steel ball bearings, we use high performance plastic bushings that don't corrode and are water lubricated. Note that because of that, you should only run the thruster in water or when it's wet, since the bearings do rely on the water for lubrication. On the other side is the cable entry, which is potted for protection from the water and then covered by a nose cone. The cavity between the nose cone and the thruster is flooded during operation, so there are holes in the nose cone to let water drain out. The cable is flexible and has a polyurethane jacket. It optionally comes with a wet link penetrator that's rated to a depth of 950 meters. This is the rotor, which is the other half of the motor and the singular moving part of the thruster. It has neodymium permanent magnets installed in an iron flex ring. Both the magnets and the flux ring are coated with multiple layers of a protective coating and platings to make them impervious to corrosion and salt water. The exposed parts of the rotor, like the motor shaft, are made of marine-grade 316 stainless steel. The thruster rotor and propeller have two vent holes on top to improve water cooling in the thruster. The propeller is installed on the rotor with two screws, and then the rotor is assembled onto the thruster core like this, and then a shaft collar is installed on the other side to hold it in place. The last part of the thruster is the nozzle, which surrounds the propeller and has a hydrodynamic design to increase thrust. The nozzle also has M3 threaded mounting holes to make it easy to install the thruster on your vehicle. The T200 thruster is a three-phase brushless motor, meaning that the commutation of the motor phases, which creates rotation, is done electronically by an electronic speed controller. Unlike a brush motor, which has two wires, the thruster has three wires, and they must be connected to a three-phase motor controller like our basic ESC. The speed controller connects to a battery or a power supply and requires a PWM input signal. If you want to test the thruster or control it manually, you can use the thruster commander to provide that signal. In most robotics applications, however, like the Blue ROV2, the signal comes from a control computer or microcontroller. The thruster's speed can be controlled to vary the thrust, and it can be run both in forward and reverse. The thrust is a little more optimized in the forward direction, so that it has about 5.3 kilograms or 11.5 pounds of thrust in the forward direction, and 4.1 kilograms or 9 pounds in reverse. The product page for the T200 has a lot more technical details and comprehensive performance charts at different voltages. We also have dimensional drawings and 3D CAD models. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.